One love.
Well, great start there from Chen.
She's got her own name on her edging tape. Can't say I've seen that before.
Love two.
Fantastic backhands, spraying it around.
Yeah, very positive for Chud. Who is the highest ranked Chinese player after the big four?
Into the middle, pinning her, and then the softballs she earned. Great winner.
Arguably our biggest cheer of the day already. Yeah, difficult for her. You saw how close it was to the body for Chen Xingtong.
Couple of touches of the net. Did well to get the first one back soon, but couldn't for the second. Double trouble.
Three, two.
Still trailing soon.
Fraser, you've been following table tennis for a long time. Where does Sun Ying Sha, for you, kind of rank up there with the other superb Chinese players that we've seen over the years? You know, Chen Meng's been a former one. You've got the Ding Nings. Where is she for you?
In terms of level, right up there with even the likes of Deng Yuping, but she still has it to prove in terms of winning titles, okay. Winning big events.
You're talking about the Olympics, right?
Talking about the Olympics and at least another world championships. They'll be held in Qatar next year, the individuals.
So the current accolade she has, you think more needs to be won?
Well, she has a world championships and an Olympic silver. That's not enough to call her the greatest ever, but the potential's there. That's why the fans are here. All these fans are looking to be on the right side of history. They can sense the potential that she has to be one of the greatest sportswomen of all time.
Players, please play on.
That was an opportunity for Chen Xingtong, which she didn't take.
And it's swung already here.
Yeah, after a pretty decent start for her. Won 5 points in a row. Sun Ying Sha. Just how quick was that?
It's a pinball machine. A switch came from Chen Xingtong, and what a switch it was. Stunning snap of the wrist there. Still two ahead with two serves, Sun Ying Sha. I mean, the recovery of both of these players already, just absolutely magical.
Yeah, that one there from Chen.
It's their shot tolerance. It's how they take the hit.
Yeah. And then sometimes return it with interest. Not always.
Five, seven.
Chen's still in this first game.
Half long push. Gets the spin up and then already has the bat high. And body weight hunched over, ready to counteract that topspin.
coming into this event, Shunying Sha. 14 matches played, 13 wins.
5-8.
And that only loss, there you go, 6-8 to Shunying Sha, was Aika Mukherjee in the World Team Championships. That was certainly an eyebrow-raising moment,
to say the least. I mean,
yeah,
just absolutely, you can't describe what kind of win that is.
I think you and me were commentating at the World Team Championships on another match, and then that one flashed up on our screens. And we were getting so excited, because just because of what it represented.
Let it six.
World number one beaten by someone, a rank outsider.
A ringer.
Yeah.
With a long pip style.
Right, even more, but that was probably what helped.
Yeah, yeah. Nice from Chun Chin Tong, and she's a point away from levelling here. The speed, the in and out footwork. It's active, proactive play. And Sin keep her nose in front. She cannot.
Wow. Oh. All square. Remember, neither one of these players has dropped a game yet in this event. This is what Fraser was referring to earlier. That's unusual, right?
Yeah, I mean, to have the edge and tape in that position, no, that's not unusual, but the name on it, I like it. Bit of extra advertisement. She made a really good spin up there, Chen. Off a decent push. But it was the angle of it. A lot of players, when they're up against a really spinny ball, actually try and aim for the net. But these players train so much, day in, day out, it just becomes instinct. Nothing they're really thinking about the shot, but where to put it.
She has a game point here, Shunying Sha.
What does she apologise for here? I think it hit the top edge of her racket. Supreme from Chun Chin Tong. The Shunying Sha backhand, after all the little touch play there. So fiery, but
players, please play on.
Just dead ice cool, Chun. It's been a fantastic first game.
Yeah, really good. Kind of different from the other two matches, the opening game. Wow, Chun Chin Tong now has a game point here. Well, this is some pressure here on Shunying Sha. Would you believe it? Shunying Sha has dropped her first game.
Love one.
First point of this game two goes to Chun Chin Tong.
Love love.
Well, you can sugarcoat it. Sue's not been at her very best so far, but has she been allowed to be? The biggest threat in the world of table tennis is the Sun Ying Sha forehand. If you want to remove it, you've got to be flipping good at the backhand to backhand trades.
2-1.
Well, this is unfamiliar territory for Sun Ying Sha so far in this event. A game and a bit down.
Ball three.
She's not even had an easy run, the world number one. Had Yuan Jianan, European top 16 champion, beat her 3-0, brushed aside Yi Xian, and then Miwa Hatamoto once more.
Four, two.
Chen Xintong up to this point has only played European players, including the European champion Polkanova, who she beat 4-4-4. Dusted her. So tough to say, actually, in terms of this event, who's in better form. But in terms of seasonal wins, obviously Sun played more matches.
5-2.
And of course, has won most of them.
Well, look at that. It's not often you see that. Worth taking a picture of that. Snapshot. Chen Xintong, 12 of the last 16 points. Huge, 75%. Of the last 16 points have gone her way.
3-5.
And the fans may be trying to play their part here, getting right behind Sun Ying Sha when she wins that last one.
This backhand from Chen. One of the best I've ever seen from her. Sun somehow manages to get it back. Oh, wow. Managed to trap the spin on the serve there, Chen Xintong, but a whirlwind pivot. But she can't find the 2-point streak to level up here, Sun Ying Sha. And the jayos of the crowd, meaning add oil, go again.
Yeah, she certainly needs to grease the wheels a bit here and get going, because she's a little bit far behind.
7-4.
Chen Xintong goes 2-up. Of course, you know the kind of player that Sun Ying Sha is. You cannot rest on your laurels.
4-8. 5-8.
Human error. Still the momentum. Heavily with Chen Xintong. Shuffle serve from Sun.
8-6.
Something different.
Yeah, again, looking to try and get back on that comeback trail, which she attempted earlier. Remember, Sun is the defending champion. Chen in her first ever Singapore Smash quarterfinal.
Oh, the length.
8-7.
Just enough for a player of Chen Xintong's level to come in, but barely got any space with the back edge. Now that is a good touch from Sun. Yeah, she had a disappointing loss by her standards to Han Ying at the last edition. Great win there for the European number one shopper, but here playing far better Chen Xintong. And a bit of fortune for Sun Yingsha.
Yeah, definitely.
What a time to get that kind of net. It's four in a row for Sun Yingsha. She's playing so positively here.
Well, given the position that she was in, Sun Yingsha, to where she is now, fantastic. But she still has some work to do. Well, she's got the game point here, Chen Xintong. Imagine if she goes two up. Chen Xintong, this is outstanding from her. She's gone two up here. Now, you mentioned Qatar 2020, Chen Xintong with a one and only win in their six meetings against Sun Yingsha. She won that 4-0.
4-0.
And, well, if she can do that here today, that really would be a huge story.
Because her points will reset. And obviously she won it last time, so that's 2,000 points gone. So if someone close to her can win 2,000 points, that'd really narrow the gap. Because she's been 4,000 points ahead of everyone for ages.
Yeah, well clear. Yeah, for a long time. You're right. And the conventional thinking has been that it was Sun Yingsha and one other to join her at the Olympics, of course. That's not to say that won't still happen. you'd still have to say should still be China's top choice.
One, three.
She is the shoo-in, the sure shoo-in. Number two definitely up for grabs. Will it be Chen Meng, defending champion, who's getting a little bit older? Will it be Wang Manyu, Wang Yidi, or maybe even Chen Xintong? Tried to blast it there, didn't she?
Yeah, went for it. By far her best start so far, Sun Yingsha. This is more like it, isn't it, really? On Sun Yingsha. Taking a long time to get going.
Top of the net there, Chen Xintong. Gets you into the middle, Chen Xintong. Off a wider serve from Sun. You've got to hold the shot. It's knowing when to kind of let go. It helps you get the precision off a ball that you're not fully behind.
Well, the pressure back on here. She was in a very dominant position a short while ago, Sun Yingsha. Just a point in it here, Chen Xintong. Relieving that just as it was building up.
Nibbling away at her ankles here, Chen Xintong. She's playing like she wants this more.
Yeah, I mean, she's not. Even when Sun Yingsha was dominating this third game and it was in a really good position, she stuck to it, didn't she, Chen Xintong?
If that comes back. That comes back. That's a top 10 shot of the event.
Hard one for her to do.
Heart must have skipped a beat for a second because that was not far. She knows it.
There's that fan club. For Sun Yingsha. Still hangs in the balance, this one. We've known how well Chen has been playing.
Five, eight.
But a three-point lead at this stage. Shun Yingsha in a decent position here. As Fraser mentioned, 2-0 in a best of seven. It's a long, long way to go. Just got the edge. Didn't look particularly amused there, did she?
Sun, play on.
Ah, she was having a look at things on the screen.
Well, that's a wicked backhand. From Sun Yingsha, who may just be starting to find her feet in this match now.
I think it's also worth noting that Sun Yingsha has been fighting on a lot of fronts as well. She's been on court for a long time.
6-10.
A lot of matches, more than 3 hours on court. Four game points for Sun Yingsha. So Sun Yingsha pulls one back to the delight of this crowd.
You don't want to let her get accustomed to the rhythm that you're playing at. Could be commentating for the rest of my life and I'd be talking about variation of pace, spin and speed.
Yeah.
Like every single match, because that is the most important thing in the sport.
Someone like Sun Yingsha wants it to come at pace, right? At her.
At a predictable and constant pace. We call it training pace when you're trying to develop your stroke. You got to change it up, whether that's through spin, through added or less power, and direction or redirection of play. Just be unpredictable.
Mm.
You barely got any space and time as it is.
Oh, that was a chance there, wasn't it, on the backhand for Sun Yingsha?
Great serve,
yeah, fantastic.
Same motion. Only two serves Sun Yingsha does is forearm pendulum and forehand shovel serve. Maybe. That's why it's so surprising if something long and fast comes. It's the same motion.
Well, you were talking about variation earlier on. I guess it's literally served her well, isn't it, so far? Those two types of serves.
But it is variation. I'm talking about the motion before the point of contact.
Fans enjoying themselves here in the Infinity Arena. Why not? It's been a real treat for them.
Whistles past her there. Looking a bit more relaxed here, the Sun Yingsha fans.
Yeah, they probably feel that she's turned the corner.
3.
A bit feisty backhand there from Sun.
Chen just a point behind now. She's been standing toe-to-toe with Sun Ying Sha today in the rallies. And more often than not won those as well.
Well, overall, Sun has won more points because of the difference in score, I think, of the last game.
5-4.
First two games were separated by a margin of 2 points. So she's basically just ahead in terms of overall points right now, Sasha.
And she's ahead by two here in this one.
Play on. 4-7.
3 points clear now. Sun Ying Sha.
The legacy event after the Worlds.
Yeah.
8-5.
Up by three here. Sun Ying Sha now. I think she'll feel a little more comfortable still. Just want to wrap this up, bring it to 2-2. Last year, when she was given an almighty scare by Ju Chunhui, Sun Ying Sha, that one went the distance.
7-8.
Chun Sun Tong has been snapping at her heels. You're having a timeout. You feel she got there first to the table?
Thought so, but we'll look at it back later. Anyway, she levels up here, and there's some serious, serious pressure on Sun to win this game. She has the serves. I'll help her execute on whatever she hoped for when she called that timeout.
9-8.
Well, she was under some pressure here, Sun Ying Sha. She called the timeout, leading by 1 point, which is where she's at again.
It's a big celebration from the world number one there.
Not over yet, this one. Oh, the thinnest of edges. Chen Qingtong
kisses it. What about that for a Sun forehand as well?
Well, an overwhelmingly Sun Ying Sha crowd. My goodness, she could be 3-1 down here. and a couple of points, but discount Sunding Sha at your peril.
Let. No flash, please.
Had that Nine a lot oh. over the last few days. Crowd with the flash on their phones. Just as Jensington was about to serve.
Nine, 10.
And it's Sunding Sha who has game points. Just the one. Good backhand, wasn't it, from Jensing Tong?
He's just unleashed all of that kinetic energy there. What an absolute belter of a backhand.
Two clear points required. This has been quite a battle, hasn't it, between the two of them? Look at them, these fans praying. Off that ben serve 11. Again. Sunding Sha effective. Second game point.
That's a fantastic 11-0. Couple of forehands there from Chun. She knew Sun couldn't produce a shot of power the way she span it into that middle unless Sun made a drastic compound movement. Sun couldn't do enough to fence it either side to prevent that Chen Xintong forehand winner. How are these coming back, man? Wow!
Wow, Chen Xintong now, for the first time in this fourth game, has a game point.
Couple of teardrops already coming down. Serious concern
wow.
from the Chateau fan club here.
I've got to say, I didn't see that. So there was some tears already.
You not see my face?
Yeah. I don't want to, Fraser, right now. Well, that is 11, fantastic for Chen Xintong.
I'm loving the side-cutting push of Chen Xintong. Because when you come into it with that way, it's not obvious, or as obvious as where you're going to put it. Took a couple of shots after, but still. Showing good outside the box thinking with the touch play as well, Chen Xintong.
Yeah, that's so important, really, when you're playing someone like Sunding Sha. Big cheers every time she gets a point now, of course, with this match in the balance. Wow.
Wow.
1-3.
Just a brace. Light speed, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what she wants.
Let 1-3.
Again, Jones Dong's had this ability to keep herself in each game. Even the ones where Sun Yuxia's played really well. The one that she won, Jones Dong, just keeping pace with her for much of it.
3-0.
Solid stuff from Chen Qingtong.
Well, we don't want to get ahead of ourselves here, but if Chen Qingtong does somehow pull off this remarkable victory over Sun Yuxia, it really would be quite something, because she has very much dominated women's table tennis for some time now, the singles sub-event.
And it all started from that cup finals win here in Singapore.
Time wasting. Please play on.
Sun Yuxia now getting a yellow card for time wasting as well.
5-3.
Yeah, both on the same card now.
Was the year though, wasn't it, for Sun? Champions Macau winner, cup finals, won the smash, side contender Ljubljana, champions in Xinjiang, and then the women's finals, and the star contender Lanzhou, not to mention the star contender Doha. Chen Qingtong hasn't seen anything near that level of success.
Yeah.
3-7.
Wow, this is huge. This man, 5 points in a row, and 4 is the absolute key number here. That is her lead. That's her lead. This is. Of course, sometimes when that dawns upon you as well, we've seen players kind of freeze up in these situations. But she has, repeat again, she has beaten Sun Yuxia 4-0 in the past.
What?
Ah, down the line. The riskier of the two shots. She went for it. Chen Qingtong.
Her backhand that we've seen today has been the best out of all of the Chinese women. Frisbeed it out. Absolutely unreturnable from Chen Qingtong. As was that. More kind of placement emphasis there from Sun.
Is this still alive for Sun Yuxia? A couple of little punches there from her. Will the knockout blow be landed by Chen Qingtong? Not giving up without a fight, Sun Yuxia. Still leads by two, Chen. Needs three to win it. Oh. Oh, the net, huge. Huge part to play in that point. And not really much acknowledgement from Sun Yingxia either. Oh, there we go. Okay, that was one. So Sun Yingxia has battled back.
It's unbelievable. Unbelievable.
She looked in real trouble.
The Chen Shintong timeout has helped Sun Yingxia. Goodness!
She's reeled off all these points in a row now. They've taken six of the last eight under real pressure and now in the lead. Wow, this is... I could go either way here, Fraser. Really could.
Well, every time the game's got to a stage where a margin of two has been required, Chen Shintong has won it. Could she break the curse here, Sun Yingxia, with her serves? Crucial for the defending champion.
Whoever wins this moves on to either game or match point. It is Sun Yingxia. Game point for her to get within one of Chen Shintong. Well, Sun Yingxia back from the dead. She looked to be in serious trouble.
One love.
You wonder now whether Sun Yingxia can draw it level. Remember, this one has to go the distance for her to win the match.
Fighting hard here, Chen Shintong.
We've talked about scar power in the past before, Fraser. And 8-4, 8-5 up in the deciding game. The finishing line's in sight. And you can't quite see it through.
1-3.
It can be in sight, but it can't be in mind. And I don't know where Sun Yingxia found that run of points from when she literally had no choice but to.
Yeah, back against the wall.
We're going to have to make another comeback here after that pretty poor miss by her standards.
4-3.
Just trying to slow it down, but there's then slowing it down so much. It makes it easy for a player like Sun Yingxia to anticipate and just kill it. So it's such a fine line when you are trying to change the pace. Oh, again, it's that switch down the line from Chen Shintong that's been just outstanding. It's blinking, you miss it, just a blur.
Oh, that is a great shot down the line. You're right.
side spinny flick. Not much top spin on it, so it takes an extra bit of physicality to come actually a little bit more up and through that ball rather than just straight over it. And that helps her. Just stay ahead here.
And of course, while we talk about the potential comeback here for Sun Yingxia, the simple equation is, of course, Chen Qingdong wins this game, she can still go through. Well, she plays shots like that. She has an opportunity, and Fraser, I mean, it's already shaping up to be a similar situation to the last game for Chen Qingdong. How often can you dig yourself out of trouble? Well, I guess if you're Sun Yingxia, you know, you have the ability, you back yourself to do it.
But then again, you're barely ever actually in trouble in terms of the scoreboard, so how used to these situations are you? I mean, I know the Chinese national team do a lot of pressure play situations where they basically imagine that they're losing to a player. They're on the receive. What do you do? Depending on who you're against and what their intentions are, what their style is. But here, the Singapore Smash Quarters, can't replicate the pressure. So what you're feeling in these moments, and Chen Qingdong again.
Well, we're near where we were in the last game.
Five.
She just keeps herself within the mix. Well, 3 points ago, we had a superb rally.
Fanning backhands out the middle.
Oh. 3-6.
Poetry in motion. Even though she hasn't been facing match points here, Sun Yingxia, in any game, any moment, should I say, this would still be such an unbelievable comeback.
Yeah, agreed. Yeah, you knew that was going to happen there. Set herself up nicely, Sun Yingxia. Chen Qingdong, she still maintains the lead. It's the all-important factor here, even if it's just 2 points. Not quite as dominant as the lead in the last game. Look at that, you just saw Sun Yingxia annoyed.
You cannot hit a forehand any better than that. Predatory from Sun Yingxia.
Yeah, they are loving it. They still need to keep their support going. She is still trailing in this overall, Sun Yingxia. Still managing to do this, Chen Qingdong.
Two is the lead and two is the need.
Oh, very good. How did you manifest that?
Learn from the best.
Three match points for Chen Xingtong. We saw comebacks already for Sun Yingsha. This one would be pretty special because there's zero margin for error now. We are talking millimeters here away from going out, Sun Yingsha. So tight, and there's still two match points to save. What do you think, Fraser? Do you think she can do it?
She can, but will she? Chen Xingtong has two bites of the apple remaining with serves here to take out the world champion.
This is hardcore. Chen Xingtong is through to the semi-finals of the Singapore Smash 2024. She's beaten the defending champion.